We Black South Africans, we call him Isanusi, which means the chosen one. This is to show how Africans, especially in the Guni side, when they build their houses, they build them in a round shape. Reason being, they represent a womb of a woman. The one that we see up there, according to the Guni speaking people or to the Zulus, it belongs to Shaka. And this one belongs to Nandi, the mother of Shaka. And this one belongs to the aunt. It's a circle of life that says what goes around must come around. And the dark cloud says when days are dark, friends are few. On the 11th and after the 11th, people were scared to go to America. To show that you are speaking about America originally in an American flag, their documents, example, their passport and the currency, we find the hawk. The calabash says African continent. Why the hawk and the calabash? It is because America was and still controlling Africa even today. The red paint is the blood. The water says over the seas of Africa, and the skull represents the man that attacked the Americans, Osama bin Laden. In 2012, the Americans questioned the former President Barack Obama's office and said, Mr. President, you said you killed bin Laden. We don't have a problem as a country, but let's see the bodies they prove. His answer was his body was buried well into the sea, into the water. Look where the skull. That's the signature of the Credo Mutwa 1979. In 1979, when America was fighting with Afghanistan, Osama bin Laden was working for CIA. He is their product, believe it or not. In 2013, we had an offer from the White House wanting to buy this painting for $8 million. Unfortunately, Credo Mutwa refused to sell the painting. A reminder that we get from our elders using Credo Mutwa as a messenger to remind us, all the men of this world, that women are so strong and powerful in this earth. As the men of this world, we need to respect, honor, and protect our women, because women possess powerful energies that we, the men of the world, don't possess. Yes, we become arrogant, we don't accept that women are powerful. But if we can give them the chance to lead the world, we like it or not, there'll be no hunger, no starvation, or unnecessary wars. Hence, in Sesotho, there is an idiom that says, Musadi. It says the way the women are so powerful, the way they've got guts, they can assist a lioness when it's pregnant to give birth. At the same time, they can tame any dangerous creature in this world. That is why the mother, sitting on top of the male, dangerous, hungry lion, she is taming it to show the strength and the power women possess in this world. This is where African rituals were performed. African stories were told. One of the greatest teachings that came out of this place, that it was how, for the children of Africans, how Africans used to pray before Moffat, Livingstone, and other missionaries who came into Africa to introduce the Western Christianity, carrying the Bible and the gun. Africans, when they pray, they would start with the mother. They would say, in the name of the mother, the father, not the son, but the child. The father has 1, 2, 3, 4 different faces. That face in the 4 cardinal points of the earth. They represent the 4 races, which is the blacks, the whites, the yellow, and the red. The colors are the mixed breeds of the 4 races. That is why we find a human skull in the pole in the middle. It is to show that in this world, we can fight and brag upon our races, but once we remove our skins, we are the same. In this world, there is only one race that lives, which is a human race. The garden of love grows into the grandmother's heart, which is a woman. There are 2 boys who are sitting on top of a lap. If you look at the boys, you could tell that the boys are fighting, they're not happy. Fighting over a stupidness, we find a positive teaching. Those boys are fighting over a penis. The one that is pointing with a fist has a big penis. Belittling the one with the 2 fists with a small penis, he wants to react violently. The teaching that we get there is, as people, we should stop fighting over small things. We always focus on the negative than on the positive. Today we worship and praise material more than anything else in this world. We no longer respect a human being. And that material brings hatred, jealousy amongst us. That is why I introduced that girl. Her name is Lerat Onolitando, which means love. She says, guys, come on, let's stop all the hatred. Let's stop fighting over small things. Let's stop jealous. Let's come together, embrace each other, and make this earth a better, powerful place. In the name of the mother, the father, and the child.
Remember, the body is just a container that contains the inner humble child inside of you. If we can allow our inner children to come out and showcase the peace that they have, the world will be a wonderful place. I'm going to introduce the symbols. With the symbols, we can be able to communicate. The diamond represents a woman. Reason being, a diamond is a precious and a strong stone, just like a woman. A fish, it's a symbol of good life. The hourglass, the two diamonds that are attached to the tips, represent us, the men. The top diamond says, as the men of this world, we were brought in this earth to embrace the beauty and the creativity of a woman. And the bottom one says, it's our responsibility to shelter and protect our families. The round ball is the full moon that represents fertility. The message on the wall is, a man and a woman were brought together to live a good life under the eye and the guidance of the full moon. And this site is to show how Africans used to bury people before the modern way. In Africa, a long time ago, when you respected the elders, living a positive life, when you die, you will be, when they bury you, you will be honored by seated up straight, face the east, and be wrapped with a cow skin. Why the cow skin? In Africa, we say a cow gives birth to a human being. They are taking you back into the mother's womb, so that whenever there is a new child in the family, your spirit can jump into the child, and you've been replaced spiritually. That is when they finish closing that grave. When you do evil things, you become a bad person. When you die, your body will be thrown upside down into the grave. They won't close the grave so that the vultures and the dogs can eat the flesh. Why the culprits are buried like that? Because of their evil, they cannot reincarnate. They got to go with their evilness. We all write RIP, which stands for?
Rest in peace.
I say return if possible. Or rise in prosperity.